right, here we go, YouTube. Are you tired of your boring speakers? Well, I'm gonna get you 10 to 15 more decibels. So we're gonna install a 6.5 200 watt peak, 100 watt RMS, 6.5 for the front kick panels. And for the front and the rear, we've got 4-inch kickers, KS series. So these are the KSC 40s. I did one side so that way I can make this video a little bit faster just to see what I'm dealing with. But as you can see, Ford puts these plastic speakers in the enclosure. So you're definitely gonna need this mount, which is provided in that 6.5-inch box. What you're gonna have to do also is take off these two tabs on the top. So snip these off, they just break off. And for the rear, as you can see, there's only two. And on kicker series, there is four, so these also just bend off. And that should be pretty straightforward. I went ahead and added some Dynamat. This is about a 6x6 square cut along the edges, and I just shoved those into one of the speaker compartments, and that gives me a little bit better sound, so it doesn't sound like you're in a bucket. But as you can see, there's a big difference between factory and what Kicker offers. So factory speakers are paper, and you know, for what it's worth, they're decent, but being that I'd like a little bit more sound and a little bit more bass and clarity, especially without spending the money for the B&O system, these things are awesome. So again, the KS series, it's a little bit better quality than the CS. Plus, if you'll notice, paper will fade and it'll turn like a cardboard color over time. These are UV protected like materials, so they'll stand up to a little bit more bass, and they'll also step up with the sunshine and any elements like water that could potentially get into your Bronco. Hopefully not, but sunlight UV protection is a killer for some of the speakers because it just erodes this stuff, which is just glue. They just spray it on at the factory because they're not thinking you're gonna spend too much time on these. But let me get started and I'll show you what I'm doing. I'm gonna work from back to front. Little tools here. Right. So what I've noticed on these rear speakers is you don't really need a tool. You just squeeze and pop them out with both hands. So once you get these things out with both hands, you can go ahead and unscrew the speaker with the Phillips head, and then you can go ahead and start crimping with these. I'll show you here in a second what that looks like, but let me put the phone down. Yep, so basically with that connector, you just squeeze and pull out. Straight out is fine. You're not gonna hurt anything. All right, as you can see, it was just two Phillips head screws on the tops. And then what I like to do is just take these connectors, again, male, female, and you just kind of push down and pull out. And ta-da. Out with the old. And then what I like is to separate these with these little T-clips. So let me get started on that. All right, so I got the T-clips on. I just give myself enough room to where if you screw up, you can always put electrical tape over the connections, because they right now they don't have a connector for this, for factory. Again, this is the 21 to 22 Ford Bronco. So with these connectors, you're just gonna plug in some of these guys, and from there I'll show you how we install the speaker. All right, this is the Dynamatic Stream. Again, 6x6, I just cut the corners. And we're just gonna take that and place that in there so you don't cover up the wires, but that'll at least drown out some of that bucket noise that I hear. Okay, as you can see, I got the rear speaker in. I got the 6 inches of Dynamat pushed to the back. And then now, just replace the grill cover and just line it up straight in those little clips and just give it a push from the bottom to the top. That's it. Okay, so now the back ones are done. Let's move on to the front. I already got this edge popped up. What I like to do is stay closest to the windshield, just grab, pop these things out, and then push a little towards her because there's a little lip. Put that to the side, and then what you're going to need is a 7mm socket. You know, I did the other side and it went relatively fast, but the hardest part of this job, honestly, will be those 6.5s. I mean, I feel like anybody can do this, just be careful of the windshield. And then just remember that you are so close to the dash that just be careful not to scratch it. But there's not a lot of space. So even if I had a camera person, I wouldn't really have a whole lot of room. Sorry about the cuts on my hand. A little cat didn't want to go to the vet this week. I don't blame him. And there's two little clips. Sorry, there's two little tabs. And these things just pop out. Again, there's that male-female clip on the back. Just unclip it and pop it out. It's kind of crazy I'm doing this one-handed. This clip right there. Just get it in. This is the new speaker, a little kicker. I'm gonna be using, again, the little T-clips, and those just clip onto those wires, and they're kind of self-crimping. They kind of tear the wire open, so it's pretty fast, but until they get connectors, it's the best I can do right now, because I'm not gonna solder this close and over my dash. But hold on, let me get these things clipped on. Okay, that's all wired up. As you see, the T connectors are going to the back of this, and then this thing just goes in there, and then you just put the screw on, and you're pretty much done with those. Next clip is going to be these 6.5 inch with that brake pedal and stuff in the way, but I'm confident I can do it because I did the passenger side first and I feel like I know what I'm doing now. So let me stop this. All right, now we're on to the front 6.5 inch driver side. So first you're gonna want to remove this panel. And then this panel, to get this panel out, you have to lift up on this. And this thing will just slide over to the right. Just beware of those clips. I haven't yet taken this off because this foot little stop here might be in the way. So let me get started and I'll see what it looks like. But this stuff just pulls up from the front. Beware of the tabs. And then you'll start exposing stuff relatively quick and easy. All right, let me get going. Okay, so this piece came up loose. The grill piece kind of slides. There's two clips in the back, and that takes that off. One of the things that's tricky, and it's hard to see because it's pretty well molded in, is this piece comes off, and that exposes that deep well bolt down there. I'm gonna see what size that is. It looks like 10 millimeter deep socket. So let me try. Okay, so that is definitely a 10 millimeter deep socket. And let's get this thing out of here so we can remove this plastic piece. They are molded together. I saw that when I was trying to finagle this one kick panel off. So you don't want to force these things out because you will definitely break some trim pieces if you try forcing it out. So just take your time and figure out where these little clips are connected to. Because in some cases they might actually have a bolt holding on trim pieces. And you don't want to break the plastic around the bolt. And that thing should be coming out pretty now. Okay, set that aside. And this thing should just lift out. Hey, look up here. There's another one. See, this is why take your time before you start ripping things out. As you can see, these little rivets here, marked with the yellow, underlined with the blue, those are basically plastic welds on these rivets. You're not going to break those off, and if you do, you're going to get some really damaged trim pieces. So let's put that up here out of the way. And don't lose those bolts, because they do have little lock washers on them up top. But as you can see, that gives you access to this guy, Ford 6.5. Again, just a compression clip. Unclip that, and you're good to go there. You'll notice that when you replace these speakers, there's going to be four wires going into a two wire. You can still use the same T-clip and just put the two positives and then the two grounds together and you should be fine. But what I want to indicate here is this clip is from Ford and it goes to the outside of the speaker box. Most aftermarket speakers are going to be behind the speaker box. So what I kind of researched here was just by feeling around, they have this little access port here. You'd miss it if you didn't look for it. I just poked a hole on the passenger side, ran my wires through there, and then wired everything up. But let me get started. Okay, so there are 3 7-millimeter screws here, up here, and to the side. And when you pull this thing out, that's what's behind there. As far as airspace, it's not bad. I might throw a piece of dynamite back there. Not dynamite. It's early. All right, so let me get started with the new kicker. All right, so it's a little difficult to see, but you can do 2 clips. It's usually the first and third, so every other one, and then you can just put 2 of them in the same clip and you'll be fine. And as I said before, what I'm gonna do is just kind of show you, I'm actually gonna run my wire through this little hole that I, like this little slit that I cut. And that way I get this speaker, and this is a 6.5 KS series. The speaker goes on top of the plastic mount that they provide. Then you screw these in with 4 screws, but you're gonna have to take like a Dremel and cut those screws flat against there, because you want an even surface on this. And then you're gonna retain, I should say, the original 3 factory or OEM bolts that they give you. And again, those were just 7 millimeter, but pretty straightforward. And then you just kind of work in reverse as far as the trim pieces. And just remember that when you wire these, you want to test them before you actually get everything back together. Just because, again, you're not soldering and you're using these T-clips or T-connectors. And sometimes they don't always work, so you might have to finagle with them a little bit. But other than that, it's pretty straightforward. The video should help everybody else. I mean, it was kind of a learning experience. These 2 screws up here on the kick panel kind of gave me a run for my money at first, because I wasn't sure why that piece wasn't coming off. But pretty straightforward. I did put some leftover dynamat in there. Doesn't really make a difference, I don't think. Just a slight vibration, but had it, so I just threw it in. And that's it. Let me put this thing back together, retest it, and then make a video of me closing this thing out. So frequently when you're putting this stuff back together, you kind of forget one of your own steps, but make sure you break these tabs off so everything fits flush. As you can see, I got it wired through now, and then pretty straightforward, but take the tabs off so you have an even flush fit. Thanks. So just so you guys can see, I got the front kick panel almost assembled, speakers in place. This top is a little hard to do. You might need a magnet if it falls down in there. Snap it out, grab it. Or do a little trick. When you put this on your socket, this thing will just fall normally. Just get yourself a piece of like old electrical tape or something. Something that's gonna stick to the wall. And then just get that down in there, line it up. And then you know that once you get it started, it's not gonna fall. So, little trick that I learned from dropping nuts and bolts in places that they shouldn't go.
but so far reinstallation is going pretty smooth. I turned it on and tested it. Sounds wonderful. Talking about getting bolts stuck where they're not supposed to go. There you go. Sometimes what happens on camera is gonna happen to you guys. So again, just make sure you got a tight fit, because that thing will fall a couple of times. And hopefully that trick helps you. So I'm all completed with the speaker install for both sides. And you know, it's really hard to do a video trying to show the before and after. So what I did was I took a decibel reading before and I took a decibel reading after with basically the same song. And my results actually were better than 10 to 15 decibels. So I was in the 50s, like 55, 54, and now I'm in 70s to 80s. So you're basically talking 20 decibels of just better, clearer sound. It is noticeable. And one of the things that people don't really talk about too much is the the whole phone call aspect of this. So I was on a conference call and I could hear them so much clearer. So doing this upgrade has so many benefits to this Bronco. I don't regret it. It sounds so much better. Again, I'm just gonna say it's been 20 decibels, and again, the clarity is noticeably better. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I plan on making some more, and thank you.